Hey guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Lori Elijah, and this is Frankly Speaking with Lori. So guys, on today's episode of Mercy and EK's What Next Show, today is actually episode 8. It was all good vibes, it was all lovey-dovey, and I really had fun watching today's show. Aside last week's show, I think this is the second show that was really, really drama-free, and I had a lot of fun, you know, watching both of them do their thing, especially EK. So guys, EK for one, you know, made me so proud. I had so much fun watching how determined EK is, putting a lot of work and a lot of energy into becoming independent, you know. And I think I talked about how last week he bought his photography equipment, tried setting up his photo shoot studio, and then in today's episode he had a photo shoot session with Mercy, and he really did great. The pictures came out really, really great. But before I go into that, guys, the beginning of the show was just super, super funny. So Mercy decided to go jogging. She called us, sister promised to go with her, but the sister was too tired and was still feeling very sleepy, so the sister did not go with her. So she went alone for jogging, and then later on she went to join EK at his gym, where he had Magic, his personal trainer, you know. And then Mercy and EK had their training together. So EK was really, really, you know, excited that Mercy came to join him at the gym, because according to him, he needed extra motivation. So guys, Mercy is kind of EK's extra motivation to get him to work out really well. And from what EK was saying, he said that the last time that they both worked out together was when they were inside Biggie's house, you know. So it's been up to or over 5 months that they have worked together, so both of them has not really worked together, you know. So according to him, aside them working together because they want to get fit, he felt like them doing what they were doing at the gym, it was also another way of bringing them closer to each other. It was sort of like a couple's workout session aimed at giving them a more stronger bond as a couple, right? So after that, I think they actually spent a lot of time at the gym. I think they spent over 10 minutes of the first minute of the show showing us how EK and Mercy were working out at the gym, and somehow I almost felt bored, but because I was actually enjoying the slight banters here and there that both of them were doing inside the gym, I'm just like, okay, it's okay, I'm not gonna mind, I'm just gonna watch it. So guys, aside that, Mercy and her sister Promise, they went swimming, and whilst they were there, Mercy let her sister know that she's preparing herself for her presentation for the AMVCA. So guys, this is where I got to understand, you know, when she made that statement that these episodes that we are watching now, they were episodes that were probably shot in January or probably December last year, I don't know. But anyways, she said that she was preparing for her AMVCA speech. Guys, if you followed her stories on Instagram, you see that she actually did a presentation of awards during the AMVCA. I think she did so with Mike or EK, yeah. And she also made mention of she's trying to register for a category of best dressed during the AMVCA awards. She wasn't nominated for any of the awards, but she was determined to win that one, that particular award. And that was when she picked up her phone and called Swanky Jerry. So everybody knows Swanky Jerry. He's one of Nigeria's renowned stylist. I think he styled Aliko Dangote's daughter for her wedding. So Swanky Jerry is well, well renowned. And both of them talked about how the clothes was going to come up. Swanky said he was going to prepare her clothes and ship it, and then whatever money they win from the award, then they were going to donate it to charity. So in the midst of all of that, that was the part where Mercy's sister Promise asked Mercy, when are you going to get married? So according to Mercy, she was wondering, like, why would the sister ask her that question, you know, that probably the sister must have seen something on the internet that would make her ask her that kind of question, you know. And then Mercy said, okay, that EK has been saying that he wants to propose. So she asked her sister that, what do you think I should say if he proposed? And the sister said, say yes. So guys, at that point, I had to pause, and then I had to think that, okay, whose side is Mercy's sister on? In one episode, the sister would be saying, oh, EK should leave you alone, both of you are not engaged, both of you don't have any ties together, blah blah blah. In another episode, the sister would still be saying that, oh, if you're going to see a therapist, just know that the cause of your problem is EK. And then in today's episode, Mercy is asking the sister that, hey sis, EK wants to propose, what should I say? Should I say yes or no? And the sister is strongly vouching for EK and saying, oh, say yes, or I will help you to say yes. And I'm like, okay, Promise, it's high time for you to pick a side. If you like Ike, go ahead and say that you really, really like Ike, you know, and stop putting it into people's heads and Mercy's head that Ike is Mercy's problem. You know, I mean, there's social media trolls out there. There's also social media wahala out there that's also giving her a lot of stress. So if she wants to go see a therapist, let her go without letting her feel like Ike is the only problem that she has in this life, you know. And according to Mercy, she said, and I quote, that she is not under any pressure to get married. So even if she gets married today or tomorrow to anyone, she is still gonna be slaying. And yes, she said it. So guys, Mercy also invited a fashion stylist called Dipo to her apartment to help her with her, you know, image presentation and all of that. I think another word for that is branding. So according to her, she wants to dress in a way that people are going to see her and recognize her as a businesswoman, an entrepreneur, and a strong woman that's got a lot going on for her, you know, and she wants people to take her serious. So she specifically invited this Dikbo guy to come over and assist her with addressing and styling and image branding and all of that. And they spent quite a lot of time in preparing different outfits, and Dikbo assisted her in getting about 3 different outfits, you know, to help her you know, prepare herself for the week. And then according to Mercy, she's going to be calling him from time to time, you know, for him to help her prepare what she's going to be wearing on a weekly or a daily basis. And that was the part where Mercy also mentioned that now that Ike has started his photography business, she wants to support him by going on a photo shoot session with him. So that was when she went to meet Ike and they actually had a photo shoot session. So guys, I was super, super impressed when I saw Ike, you know, putting all his props together, you know, carrying his camera. And I'm like, oh yes, you know, earlier on the show today, guys, Ike was saying that he's tired of always calling Mercy to come over to his apartment and help him to cook. So he wants to cook for himself, you know, and let people know that Ike can actually take care of himself. And he's also trying to prove to his parents that, hey, Nigeria is not that bad, because according to him, his parents feel like Nigeria has just this kind of vibe, you know, so their fear is anything can go wrong at any time. So Ike is trying to prove to his family that, hey, I can be independent, I can take care of myself. And so guys, it's funny how to prove to people that Ike can take care of himself, he tried to cook noodles. And I'm like, okay guys, I get the part where you were trying to prove that you are actually very independent, but then cooking noodles, okay, let's see how that goes. And you know, now anybody will cook food, now go talk, say in food sweet. So Ike was saying that, oh, the food is really nice, and he wished that Mercy was there to taste the food, and even she would not be able to resist the taste of the food. And I'm like, okay, go Ike, go Ike, go Ike. And afterwards, he went for his photo shoot with Mercy, and it was all good vibes all through, because according to what he was saying, he said that he actually felt like Mercy was giving him a vibe that she wasn't there for drama or quarrels, she just wants to have a good time. And he too, he wasn't prepared for any drama, so they had fun having that photo shoot. And as I said earlier guys, I am super proud of what Ike has been able to do for himself. And I know that today's episode was actually recorded like months back, but I really, really hope that same energy that he has been putting since last week's episode and this week's episode into growing his photography business, I wish that he's still putting in that much effort, because the pictures he took Mercy were actually great. They came out really, really nice. And I have a strong feeling that if he goes ahead with all of that move, he is going to really, really break into, you know, the photography industry in Nigeria, because the photography industry in Nigeria is really, really blooming. That said guys, I feel basically that's all that happened, you know, on today's episode. And though they cracked a few jokes, you know, Ike saying that Mercy saying that she wants to do a photo shoot of nudes, and Ike said, oh yes, that he is also planning on taking his photography career to the next level by taking pictures of only nude people. And Mercy was like, nude girls only? And he said, no, but guys and girls. And Mercy gave him a strict warning, like, hey, it is only my nudes that you'll be taking pictures of. So guys, you heard it from those two people. But really guys, today's episode was really, really fun. Not a lot of drama. When Mercy's sister asked her that question, I felt like, okay, here we go again, they're trying to bring more drama to today's show, you know. But the drama was avoided and everything was all good vibes. So basically guys, that's all for today's episode of Mercy and Ike's show What Next, and that is all for today's episode of Frankly Speaking with Glory. Tomorrow guys, don't forget, I'm going to be posting videos tomorrow morning, and then the Big Brother Naija Pepper Dem Gang reunion show continues tomorrow evening. Remember guys, I post videos twice daily, my regular daily trend videos in the mornings, and also my BB Naija Pepper Dem Gang reunion in the evenings, and then Saturdays by 3 p.m. West African time is my Saturday YouTube live, where I talk about random topics majorly voted by you guys. So guys, don't forget to keep up with my channel this week, and it promises to be so much fun. And that said, that's all for this particular episode. I said that twice now. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Do have an amazing evening. Bye.